Assalamu alaikum. I am Muhammad Mahmud Hassan, Assistant Teacher, Agriculture, Greenfield School and College. Dear student of class 7, today I am going to discuss about lesson 2, Intercultural Management in Maize Cultivation and Crops Yielding. This is under chapter 5. This chapter 5 is in your fourth monthly exam. Use of irrigation. At first you have to know what is the use of irrigation. To get the production of high yielding maize variety up to the expectation level, 3 to 4 times irrigation is required. The first irrigation should be given at the 5 leaves stage, and the second one is recommended at the 10 leaf stage. That means if a maize plant contains 10 leaves, the second irrigation should be given, and the third one ensured at the time budding out of the mocha, and the fourth one should be given at the phase of taking granular shape. It should be observed that the soil in the maize field does not get water locked. In this picture, look at this picture. Figure Nong 5.2, maize plant of different stage. This is the initial stage of maize plant, and this is the final stage of maize plant, and these three is intermediate stage of maize plant. This is a life cycle of a maize plant. Now, pest control management. The maize crop suffers less pest attack, but at the seedling stage, larva of katui puka cuts the bottom of the tender plants. This insect hides at daytime and comes out at night. This larva should be dug out from the soil around the just cut plant, sand destroyed. If the attack is massive, Furadan or Darsban should be applied in prescribed amount, and the land should be irrigated again. Darsban is a medicine or is a chemical that is applied to control this larva of katui puka. This is the larva of katui puka. Now, I am going to discuss about some disease occurred in maize plant. Disease of maize. Maize may be attacked by considerable number of diseases. Example, seed rot disease and plant decaying disease. Plant decaying disease, the another name of plant decaying disease, chara mora rog. Signed leaf disease. Stem rot, mocha rot and grain rot disease. Attacks of these diseases get through various types of seeds and seed-borne fungus. Seed rot and plant decaying diseases outbreak in maize field if there is excess fluid in soil and the temperature is low. A longish gray mark is seen in the lower part of the plant when attacked by sickled leaf disease. This mark later spread to the upper part of the plant. Signed leaf disease. Signed means marked. So this mark is spread to the upper part of the plant. If the attack is massive, the plant dries up in advance and dies away. Pest control procedure. There are four procedures of pest control. Number one procedure is pest preventive variety should be used. Number two is treatment should be done before sowing seeds. Number three, the remaining of maize plant should be burned down after harvesting. Number four, cultivation of maize in the same field over and over again should be stopped. Now, I am going to describe how to collect and thresh of corns. Look at this picture. You may have some idea about this picture, how they collect, how the women collect grains from maize. This is a hand-driven thresher. This is a thresher. It is used to thresh the seeds. When the maize flower gets the color of shiny stalk, leaves become slightly yellowish. Maize becomes worthy of collecting corns. When the maize flower mellows 75% to 80%. Here, maize flower yellows. Maize flower becomes yellow about 75% to 80% of maize becomes yellow. Corn can be collected. Maize flower should be dried up in the sun for 4 to 5 days after collection of them. Then corns should be separated by hand-driven thresher or threshing machine and the preserved after shifting. Now, what is the lifespan of maize? Lifespan of maize is 135 to 155. Lifespan means the total period of life of maize. Here the total period is 135 to 155 days. But during Rabi season, the lifespan is 135 to 150. This is the lifespan during Rabi season, but during Kharif season lifespan is 90 to 110 days. Production of maize in our country is different than the foreign country. In Bangladesh, maize yield well during Rabi season and it does less in kharif season. In kharif season, life span is very low, so yield is very poor. Maize production varies between 3.5 to 8.5 ton per hectare, depending on its variety and season. Now I am going to show you something about hand-driven thresher. How a hand-driven thresher works. Now I am going to show you hand-driven thresher. This is hand-driven thresher. Look at this thresher. Here you have to insert the maize and move the paddle, move the handle. Here is the handle in the clockwise or anti-clockwise, in clockwise motion. You have to move the handle in clockwise motion, and here you have to insert the maize.
Ini adalah alat sederhana.
Now you are watching that. Simple machine. This is hand operated. Now insert the maize here, and very simple to remove the maize from the mortar.
Bersih.
Very easy. Now another one. Very easy and effective machine. You can easily remove this grain from this fruit. Now I am going to discuss about katui poka. The English name of katui poka is army worm. How army worm or katui poka damages maize crop, and how to control katui poka. So let's see this video. Watch this video carefully. This is a maize field. They are working to control katui poka or fall army worm.
Fall army worm, Spodoptera fugipeda, is a devastating pest of maize crop. This
fall
pest
army
is
worm.
Recently being introduced in India and causing huge losses to maize crop.
this
cartoid
coca
or
army worm
it's been introduced
attacks,
into Africa
in
a
maize
couple of years
crop.
Back started threatening the food security of African countries. This pest was identified in India in Karnataka state in the month of May 2018. Since then it started appearing in many places. This current season this pest is found in thousands and thousands of acres of maize crop in South India. Fall armyworm has a life cycle of 30 days. The adult moth can travel about 100 kilometers in a single flight. An adult female moth can lay about 1000 eggs in a life cycle. Even though there are chemicals recommended to control this pest, but the experiences in South American countries says that now this pest has a capacity to develop resistance quickly against any pesticide which is being used. Even though maize crop is a preferred host of fall armyworm, it can also affect more than 80 crops. The Indian Council of Agriculture Research had already released a pest alert on fall armyworm. Dr. Rama Naidu Ekalavya Foundation Krishi Vignana Kendra, Tuniki, Medak district in Telangana state, has come up with very simple, effective and innovative solution to manage this pest. The scientists of KVK Medak have tried different non-chemical options like soil, rock dust, charcoal powder, wood ash, agni astra, hypomea concoction, salt, green chili solution, waste decomposer, etc. Among which, application of soil in the horals has given excellent result, followed by application of rock dust, charcoal, wood ash into the horals. Soil can be directly applied in the horals and then a little water can be poured. If it is raining, no need to pour water. The other method of application of soil, we can make a thick slurry of soil and it can be poured into the horals. The next day after application, the activity of the larvae ceases. There were no frost material or excreta found in the horals. The larvae slowly stops feeding and it will starve and it will die in next 3 or 4 days time. Meanwhile, the affected corals will recover fast and they can emerge quickly. The youngest leaf will be fresh and healthy. This non-chemical, eco-friendly, simple method of managing fall armyworm gives multiple benefits. It is very cheap and economical for the small and marginal farmers. It will conserve the natural enemy populations in our ecosystems. We can avoid the use of poisonous chemical substances.